agree, disagree, because it's not something that's like set in stone or anything. Okay, next slide. Okay, so roughly my work with schools over the last 15 years, I can break up into two sort of demarcations. One is using drama and music as a tool to help specific skills. And the second is nurturing a culture of engagement. The discovery of theatre and the arts by students is something to be enjoyed of itself. And very often, it's easy to forget the second point. We're so focused on the first one that the second point sort of happens along the way but doesn't quite. And the minute it's put down like that, then you just kind of make sure it's happening, you know, alongside whatever else you're doing. Okay, next slide. Thanks. So this was the first category, drama as a tool. And that I've broken up into further sort of demarcation. And one that we use drama and art as to learn about a particular topic. And this is the most common thing that principals will ask you to do. Oh, help teach diction through singing, or environmental issues through a street play, or discuss gender issues through a workshop. And all of these are very valuable, because obviously they communicate to children in ways that other things don't. And in each case, except for the diction through singing, in each case, we try and make sure that there's enough space for the students' contribution. Let them discover certain things, and also it's creating the boundaries that free in a way. It gives them sort of a rail to hold on to, so they're not conscious, but that suddenly frees them to express themselves. The second demarcation is using drama and art as a tool to learn a particular skill, where helping them develop skills as an orator or an actor or a scriptwriter or a singer, musician, dancer, all of these. And also we know that helps in teamwork and people skills, self-confidence, discipline. These are things that parents are interested in. The first one, principals are interested in. These are the things that parents are interested in, and they're willing to invest time. Before we go to the next slide, there's always that question: what about the value for the arts itself? And we all know in this room that, you know, you could walk in and see something, and it maybe doesn't affect you till years later. You know, how do you make that something that you want principals and parents to give time to, or to even see in that way? So next slide, please. What I've started doing is sort of putting it to parents and principals. Something again that I think we all know in this room, that it creates that that space for empathy, for imagination, for self-reflexivity, critical thinking, open-mindedness, and very important pluralism of perspectives, and just simply pleasure. I'm also very interested in things that, performances that are surprising or challenge familiar things, because I think we're sort of getting into a space where we only go for a performance or show when we understand what it is about, you know, where we go for the familiar things. And that for me is, you know, engagements that create that sense of the unfamiliar can be exciting. And if you do that enough times, you fuel the child's, you know, innate sense of wonder, which is there. We kind of lose it as we grow older. But it makes for really open-minded and experimental adults. So these are just some of my thoughts on performance creating or curating performance for young people. Next slide, please. Yeah, so creating experiences for the young. By this I mean things that they are participating in, not just viewing, even though that is also a kind of participation, but workshops, or if they are performing or creating or script writing. And for me, in creating that journey, the details are super, super important. So it's that detailing and that energy flow of the experience, and that knowing what the overall journey is, and that adaptability to the energy in the room, keeping in mind all those aims that we've talked about, you know, that nurturing that arts engagement as well as whatever your topic aim is. And what I think is really important is hearing the vocalization of the experience from the kids. Because in telling their stories, it sort of makes it sink further. It's also a feedback process, which is hugely important. But it makes it two-way, which is what it should be. It should not be, you know, I'm giving you something, you know, take. It's really a learning process that goes both ways.